Let's go.
Well, hey guys, I'm here early, yeah, surprise, surprise, the chapters have come out early today, on hump day, no, fucking Monday, really, Monday, wait, time out, on a fucking Monday, like, no, see, this is the problem, because it throws me off for everything, because I'm like, wait, I usually thought chapters, I mean, yeah, I understand they come out, like, a day early, like, on a Wednesday, but on a Monday of all days, that's pretty fucking bizarre, because we all know that last week, well, Thursday, we had no chapters, that Thursday, we had nothing because of Golden Week, and all of a sudden, we got early leakage, which I'm very surprised. No one, I guess Manga Stream and them are okay with it, but I'm really surprised they didn't get caught for doing this. I'm assuming maybe it's because, maybe they had some kind of early access or something, but, excuse me, but, oh man, it's just, I never expected it to come out this early. I mean, granted, I usually know sometimes on Wednesdays it does, but on a Monday, like, oh man. That throws me off, like, so much, because it's like, you know, I want to do something else in the video, but I can't, because all of a sudden, bam, they just, like, slapped me in the face out of nowhere. It's like, because I look at my subscriptions on YouTube, and I'm just, like, seeing something, because I'm on break from work, and I'm just, like, just chilling, watching some YouTube. All of a sudden, I know, look at my subscriptions, oh, look, newsflash, One Piece chapter is out, because I saw, Roger Bass's channel, and he already had the review up, and I'm like, what? Are you kidding me? So, it's out already right now, which I'm very shocked about that. So, yeah, here it is. We've gotten One Piece chapter 825. Extremely fucking early. So, I guess it's, I mean, it's only been, what, like, 3 days or 4 days since we haven't had a chapter? It hasn't been a full week yet. Like, what the hell? So, I mean, whatever. I mean, I'm not really that disappointed, but still, it's just because if I want to do Boku no Hero, but you know what? Fuck it. I'm gonna have to wait until maybe, like, tomorrow or something, because right now, when it comes to the chapters, I like to keep up to date. So, whatever, though. So, let's just get started. So, this is One Piece chapter 825. The title of this chapter, though, is really weird. It's called the Wii Times Comic Strip. The fuck is that supposed to mean? Is that a translation error? Or is that really the name of the chapter? The hell does that mean? The Wii Times comic strip. I've never heard of that as a title. Is that supposed to mean something? Is it supposed to be related to, like, the news? Is some more crazy news shit we're gonna get is gonna happen? Because we all know how One Piece, you know, hype stuff up, like, most of the time. Like, you know, meanwhile, this is happening, or meanwhile, that's happening around the world. Maybe it has to do something with that, is my guess, but are we not gonna get focused back on Cake Island again? Like, deadass? I mean, okay, whatever. So anyways, we got the cover page, and it's the, this time, it's the continuation of the 100 Million Berry Man arc. And this time, it's the sky island of Wet Daria. And, you know, the cloud island, the wetter island where Nami trained for 2 years. And we see, like, those old dudes, you know, the ones that know about the magic wetter and shit. They're just there in these weird-ass fucking suits. And they're just, like, chilling, just, like, trying to look posing all cool and shit. It's like, they look fucking goofy and weird. Like, get the hell out of here. So, yeah, I mean, I like his old wizard costume better because it actually fit his character, but him in the suit, nah. Alright, so, wait, let me go back to that. Oh, okay, that is a really badass looking, okay, that's a cool fan-made thing of Ace, though. That's, realistic. I like that. Man, they really need to post that more, like, on Tumblr or even in our, I mean, whoever did this is really amazing work. Okay, that's kind of cool. So, and, of course, we get a little coloring of, what was it, like, 12 chapters ago with that? That, again, that scene is gonna make me, like, I have a really weird feeling about that scene where he says, like, don't worry, guys, I'll be back. And he's, like, smiling. I'm never gonna forget that scene. Alright, so here we go. Finally, the chapter. The Yonko ship with Sanji aboard plows the waves. Shippu, Shippu. Oh, yeah, it's the singing ship. Oh, yes, yeah, Big Mom stuff. Oh, okay, here we go. Yes, let's go. Okay, so we are on Cake Island. Good, because I thought we were just going to, like, focus way beyond that. And then we got, like, these little soldier-looking things. I'm telling you, this has to be an Alice in Wonderland theme, because the fucking guards look like the guards you see, like, in that Disney Alice in Wonderland shit with the guards with the spades of the spades and shit. Yeah, that's what it kind of reminds me of. So I'm calling it right now. This is going to be some Alice in Wonderland shit. I mean, hey, we already got Carrot joining on board with the bunny. Why not? It actually fits. All right, so there's the comic strip that, oh, that's, okay, that's why it's called that, okay. I was wondering what the hell is going on. There's this comic strip that runs in the Wii times. It's got giant fantastical robots in it. So, Sora, Warrior of the Sea, I've been reading it for as long as I can remember. Also, it's like a book or something, or a comic? I'm assuming it's some kind of comic thing that he read, like, many years ago. And, fucking Vito is saying that Sora. What the fuck was this? Kingdom Hearts now? Sora? No, not that Sora. Not Keyblade motherfucking Sora. Not him. Oh, can you imagine? Yo, if this dude was in One Piece, oh, it would be a wrap right now. You kidding me? He would just like, oh, man. He would just like go over. Yeah, you know what? Sora, Alice in Wonderland. Jesus, this is definitely giving me Kingdom Hearts vibes and that now. Thanks, Oda. So, a hero who can walk on the waters of the ocean, along with a transforming robot, and his pet seagull, anyways, moving on. Fight the evil armies of the Gurma 66. It's a tale of seafaring heroes. It's popular the world over. No. Oh, that's his laugh thing. I forgot he does that. I wonder how it's going to sound like in the anime when we get to that, like, months from now. As far as I've heard, it's supposed to be based on the exports of marine heroes. Basically an attempt at brainwashing little kids to idolize the marines. Speaking of the anime, though, I'll get to the Kaido stuff. Because, oh my god, that was awesome. Alright, moving on. Make him think that the Marines are always fighting for the just cause, and they're that the strongest there is. No. But none of them stuff caught my fancy. I've always drawn to the Gurma myself. And Sanji's like, the evil army that spares no effort in chasing down and trying to defeat Sora. Alright. So, of course, they pretty much always end up losing. But I root for them every time without fail. All the same, with bated breath. I'm rooting for your team. Excuse me. Don't let me in with those bastards. That's what Sanji said. I don't have anything to do with them. No. Come on. Don't be like that. Sanji ain't having that shit. Like, truth be told, I'm pretty thrilled that I got the chance to meet a real one in the flesh. Oh, no. That's Vito saying that. I'm sorry. Why don't you go seek out the real army then? I'm sure you'll have a blast.
Sorry about that.
No, that's okay. Oh, no. I don't care. No, I don't care. No, don't worry about it. I don't care, baby. That's fine. Oh. Because your kendo is sucks. Kind of. Sorry to say, but.
Hey, look. I dropped it many times.
And it still survived, surprisingly.
Yeah. Thanks for this case.
Alright, so what the. Okay, so Sanji's opened up the door. Is someone like behind there sleeping? Oh, it's the door! The door is. Okay, this is definitely Alice in fucking Wonderland now. Okay, fucking talking door, yeah. Alright, we got it. Why don't we bring in Big Mom? She's the fucking Queen of Hearts. Let's just make her the Queen of Hearts, why won't we? Jesus Christ, this is definitely straight on point from Alice in Wonderland. The door is just opening. And then he just, like, he just cracks it open and he says, welcome. And then he just, like, okay. It's a really creepy-looking door, though. I don't know which is creepier, that or the doorknob from the actual movie. And so you see, quit following. This is my private room. He goes, oh, shit. Oh, hello. She's our clown? So they're going to be putting him in both in those prison cells or something? Well, not the prison cells, but... they already got, I guess, Caesar already in contempt already in the bars. It's my room too. Let me the hell out. And he goes, and then Vito's like, why does he get the prince treatment? Oh no, that's Caesar. Why does he get the prince treatment? I'm one of the world's forensic scientists, for crying out loud. So blurring on like that, like anyone gives a damn. Caesar, our orders are to take you prisoner. Yeah, no shit, because you owe mom, like, a whole bunch of, like, money from all the funds you got from the experiment. So, yeah, it's kind of your own fault. You're an idiot. And he goes, but this guy, he's the man that will bring the Vince Smoke and Charlotte families together. The man of the hour. He's worth his weight in gold. And Sanji's like, don't make me repeat myself. I ain't marrying anyone. Now get me the hell out of here. And then, who the hell is this dude? Get the hell out of here. He's got like a fucking gun for an arm. It's weird. And he's like, bold. Don't tell me this pretty boy just mattered off to Vito. Oh, okay, here we go. So, oh, okay, it's another member of, Capone's, pirate crew. Okay, so there's another member of Capone's pirate crew. Alright, that's pretty cool. So, we got Fire Tank Pirates Killer. Hold on, someone messaged me real quick. Oh, no, never mind. I think it was about something else. Yeah, that's what it was. Anyways. So Fire Tank Pirates Killer Gotti. Oh, Gotti. Okay, that's a weird name, but okay. So, okay, it looks pretty cool. So, at least we finally got another main member of Capone's family that, or whatever, their fucking crew. Yeah, pretty much. Okay. Gotti, hold your horses, man. Cool it. He didn't mean it. It's all good. He's just doing a bit of a friendly ribbling. We're just having a laugh. He goes, no one's laughing here. Get the hell out, both of you. Try saying that to my face, man. I dare you. I'm gonna let some of that insults my mates get off that easily. Oh, shit. Damn. This dude is damn. He's serious. Quit it, man. Seriously. He goes, fine by me. And Sanji's like, I don't give a fuck. He's like, are you want to fight me? I'm not in the mood right now. So I'll just take out my anger on you. Fine by me. I'm not trying to be best buds with you anyway. And then, like, what the fuck? Go deep. Oh, Lola? It's Lola. Oh, my God. Hello. I haven't seen you since Thriller Bark. Okay. I'm calling it now. Lola and Big, that's her mom. I'm calling it right now. Because, alright, remember back in Thriller Bark where she says, like, you know, my mom is cool because my mom actually hooks me up and she's able to help me go through the new world. And, you know, like, even, like, her own crew member said, like, yo, you don't want to mess with Lola's mom because she is one, like, ferocious beast. And I'm like, oh, shit. And lots of the theorists were calling this shit. We were calling this shit from the beginning that Big Mom and Lola are related. I'm calling this shit right now, man. Yo, Oda, man, he needs to chill with this. Seriously, this arc is getting better. Like, really. So, I'm calling it. I'm calling that Big, that's gotta be like one of her whatever 30th daughters. I'm assuming like her 20 something. Because the one that Sanji's marrying is Pudding, the three eye girl. So I think she might be somewhere along the line. I don't know. Maybe, but we'll find out. Do you have any idea who he is? He's the son of the Vince Smoke family. If you so much as put a scratch on him, they'll ice father in the blink of an eye. Oh shit. Want me to ice you first? I'm so sorry, miss. No. I guess we'll have to pick up the conversation about the Genma some other time. You wish. In any case, they really do look similar. Really, Sanji? How do you not remember her? Dead ass? How do you not remember that that's definitely... How do you not remember that's Lola? Oh, shit. Really? Maybe he just doesn't... Because that, again, maybe because the way Lola's appearance is... I'm assuming maybe that's the reason why, but whatever. Okay, so meanwhile, a few days later at the Thousand Sunny. Okay, we're going back to Luffy now. And it's like, it's all over. I'm dying too. What the? So they're still starving? Well, that's your own fault for pretty much giving your captain the fucking chef's hat. Like, I'm parched. Well, that again, because Sanji's not with them. What the flying fuck? Luffy looks like he's a dying old man with his tongue sticking out. Damn. And he can't make up proper sentences because it's really hot. He's thirsty. He doesn't have that much supplies. Poor Chopper looks like his tongue is sticking out. He needs water badly because he looks like he's about to die as well. So, oh my god. And then, like, Chopper's like, I'm no good in hot weather. I'm so close to tearing off all my fur. And then Pedro's like, likewise, heat is the minx Heat is the Minx, Isolus heal. Or Ixilis heal. Whatever the fuck it's called. Their weakness. Because I guess certain animals are just not used to, like, the heat temperature. Well, Chopper is obvious because he was born in a winter paradise. And I guess the others were... The trees are pretty much covered a bit more because by the way they live in Zaul. So it makes sense that they don't get too much, like, too much sunlight. So it makes sense why that they're not used to the heat. I can understand Chopper. And damn, like, Chopper really wants to get rid of his fur and get a haircut because he's, like, suffocating. And then, well, Brooke, you have no stomach, so you shouldn't talk. He sure is a sorcerer at this rate. I'll end up like a mummy. Look who's talking. Hey, Nami, wouldn't that be a little resurrection, but in my own particular way? And she goes, like, I care. In that case, now would be a good time for, you to show me your panties. And it's like, I can't even muster the strength to actually brought you right now. Aw, oh, poor Carrot. She's laying on Nami. She's just about hot as well. She goes, I'm just hot. And Carrot's like, Nami, I'm hot. I'm starving. Provide me with some nutrition. Or aka carrots.
Aww. Why Nami has to be the
We're laughing.
Why Nami's like, like, why do everyone...
Yeah.
Fish
something while you have that window before the weather changes again. Yeah, exactly. Who originally? But I'm able to fish these past few days thanks to that Tempest. And yeah, and at least Peckins is sort of hanging on. Well, I can't tell because we're wearing sunglasses. Damn, fish something son, while you have the window. Oh, I think I already read that part. Who the fuck is texting? Shit. Oh, it's comments in my other video, but whatever. Anyways, at this rate, we'll all starve to death before even arriving. Chopper's like, we really want to, Nami, but it's so hot that the sea is on the verge of boiling. Like, what? There's no way we're finding fish in these conditions. Jesus, Luffy, you look like you just reached over 100 years old. Just desperate times, desperate measures.
Just throw him in the water.
He's a Dolopher user. You do realize that he would just die. Well, not die, but like
care.
He would say.
Throw him off the
bucket. Desperate times calls for desperate. Oh no! Quit eyeing me like I'm a bot roast. Oh damn it. No, no. Poor Chopper. Aww.
You're not gonna eat him.
No, no eating him.
Fuck you.
Pedro, Luffy, your line is pulling. Carrots, food, yay. You got this, Luffy. Muster your own strength. Luffy, fight. Holy shit, damn. I'm surprised the fish can actually survive in that boiling water. I thought that thing would already be cooked by now, like a lobster. Okay, so the fish actually does come up. Oh shit, that is awesome. He's like, food. Oh my god, their desperation faces are killing me. You did it. Beckins, rawr. Brooke's like, oh, now this is a big hole. Oh, there we go. Awesome, but is it me or does his color seem a bit off or isn't even edible? Chopper is wondering that. Luffy, give me a second. I'm gonna look up this fish right now. Yeah, go for it because you don't know if this thing is like probably poisonous or not. Okay, so Chopper's trying to find. Oh, I didn't know he has that. Oh, that's kind of smart of him. He has a whole bunch of information like all in the encyclopedia of all these fishes. It's like, now. Now, where did he put that fish encyclopedia? Gosh, Sanji's library sure was full of dirty... Oh, never mind. I scratched that. That's Sanji's room. Sanji's library is so full of dirty magazines. Found it. And then... Luffy, do not digest the skin. The skin of this fish is coated in a deadly poison. Look, Sanji left a note here about it. And it's already too late. They're already just gorging right in. Oh, good God, no. The skin's delicious. For heaven's sake, Luffy, at least let me grill it. Here, take a bite, Carrot. No! Don't you? You're an idiot. She's gonna get poisoned as well. But the skin looks so slimy. Luffy. They don't care. They're starving. They're desperate. You know what? You might as well just go for it. Even if you're poisoned, hey, it's worth it. At least you survived.
Hey,
so good. I'm crying tears of joy now. I grilled it following Sanji's recipe to a T. Oh, that's... Yo, cool. All right, so... Nami's getting a little bit of those cooking lessons from Sanji, I see. Nice. Okay, that's pretty awesome. Chopper, we need to get some food in that stomach of yours. Eat up. And it's already started. Luffy already got into like a freaking coma already. And I think he's already so cold. No, Luffy's gonna die. We're dangerously low on medical supplies too. And why are you eating it, Job? Well, I don't think. Well, no, he just said the skin is not good. But I think the rest of the parts are okay. So at least they're eating the parts that are good. We're dangerously low on medical supplies. We have to find an attendant for. Oh, okay. It's weird because I think he's talking. I think it's Chopper who's talking, but he's like crying at the same time while eating. We have to find an island, Nami, soon. Not good. And then Nami's like, I know, but I just can't find one at the drop of a hat right now. And I bet I already know where the hell it's going to be at. Bet you they're already going to land on a Cake Island already. This poison supposedly causes instant death, if not mistaken. And yet he's alive. That's right. Luffy's developed strong immune to poison, didn't he? Oh, yeah. That's right. I forgot about that shit. Yeah, because when he fought Magellan back in Impel Down, he already got immune to the poison once. So it makes sense that I think he's pretty much used to it. Luffy, is he really gonna die? It's alright. The light, it's so beautiful. Don't worry, Don't worry, he's got some freakish conditions. Don't go into the light at the end of the tunnel, Luffy. A few days have passed, so Blackleg and his captors have an old Blackleg arrive at the island. Which means we should be in her territory shortly. And it's like, her territory? You've gotta be. Now it's snowing? No, those clouds. Scaharian clouds? Or whatever the fuck it is, I don't know. Precisely. What we're seeing right now is called cotton candy snow. Oh, Jesus, Chopper's going crazy. No, don't you say those words. Oh, God. What kind of candy? Like, beep, 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 beep. What the fuck is that thing? Traditional sea territorial sea slug. What the freak is that? Okay, it's like a little detector snail, is my guess. Ring, 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 ring. And that thing is ring. Oh, the Dindinbushi is ringing. I wonder who it can be. And Brooke just is about randomly going to pick it up. It's merely catching warning waves. It's just a sign that we've just crossed into Big Mama's territory, according to Peckham's. It would be wise if your crew to either hide or disguise themselves. And, and Chopper and Carrot, meanwhile, are just going nuts over the cotton candy. Just grabbing a haul, like, from the rain. I just spotted something, Peckham. That was fast. They're already here. And then, like, oh, I guess Nami and them already found it. It's our tart ship. Peckham's on the tart ship. Oh, shit. I'll simply follow protocol and procedure. Everyone, stay quiet. Oh yeah, lead us to Peckham's, because he's got this. He knows how Big Mom's islands and their ships work. They wouldn't happen to have the antidote, would they? Huh? And it says, Gurma speaking. I assume you lot are the Straw Hat crew. Damn, what the fuck? What the hell ship is that? It's like a big-ass Dindinbushi, but it's like a fucking ship. Holy crap. Okay. Wait, what? No, it's the Gurma 66 ship. I told you, because it had the fucking Dindinbushi thing, like a ship, sort of. It looked like them. It had to be. Oh, shit. Oh, damn. And wait, the eyebrow. Oh, my God. That's gotta be Sanji's. I'm gonna guess that's either Sanji's brother or Sanji's father. That's gotta be Sanji's father. Yo, that's crazy. Okay, no, it's the Gurma. Oh no. Oh shit, here we go. They're finally here. Who and what exactly is Sanji's family? The assassinations. Oh my God, the assassins. Yes, finally. Oh my God. Oh, this is good. Oh, and then, oh no, oh, and then you just have to pull that shit at the end of the chapter. No, I'm not talking about the cliffhanger, I'm not talking about that. Oh, no, those words, they hurt so much. We already know what it is. It's classic Oda, we all know what this is. And that's bullshit because we just had no chapter last week, and now, the next issue, One Piece will be taking a break. Oh, fuck you two. Really? Ugh. No. Oh, God. Well, shit. Ugh. Next week, there's no issue. So, next week, it will be on break. So, chapter 826 will not happen as the usual time next week, which sucks. It sucks so much. Ugh, damn it. Because I guess it was because it was supposed to be scheduled on the time after, like, maybe it was supposed to be scheduled before that time with, like, Golden Week is my guess, but, oh my God, no. Shit. Oh, come on, dude. That was not, and you had to end it that way with the fucking assassins. The Gourmet 66 ship. Sanji's family. Oh my God. Yes, yo, I'm mad hyped for that chapter right now. Oh my God. We're finally here right now, man. Oh my God. Oh, damn it. Oh my God. Why does he have to do this to us? Alright, overall though, the chapter, while it was just a good chapter overall, well, it was just going to be like an okay, decent chapter from what I... Actually, because it was some interesting shit. Or not even that. It was just like a good chapter in general because the comedy was really on point. It was actually really, really funny. And not only was the comedy really funny, which I really enjoyed it, was basically the ending to the chapter was good. The beginning stuff was really awesome. How, you know, we got to know more about this legendary hero named Sora who was able to actually stop the tracks of the Gourmet 66. So, you know, we learned more about that. It's some kind of comic thing that he would, like, that Vito used to read, like, years ago when he was much younger. And then we meet another member called, like, DeVito. I forget his name, whatever. I forgot his name already. The dude with the gun. We have him. And then finally, Lola. Surprise the fuck out of nowhere, Lola's back. And I'm like, wow, okay. So we got into touch. I'm calling it right now. She's probably like her 30th or maybe 20-something daughter. I don't know. But I am calling that shit right now. And I think we all call this from a mile away. Especially the way that they kind of describe it. Especially how, like, even Lola's crew even said that Mama can be a scary person sometimes. So we all know that it definitely has to be relation ties with Big Mom. So it made perfect sense that we should have saw that coming. Oh my God. So you know what? I'm going to give it a 4.5 out of 5. I'm going to give it a great, great plus because of that ending alone. Because of that ending. I mean, it just would have been a good chapter just for the comedy's sake and just knowing some stuff that was really cool and interesting about the Gourmet 66 stuff. But just seeing the dude with the sunglasses and the curly eyebrow. I don't know if that's Sanji's father or if that's Sanji's brother. I don't know. I don't know if it's his father or his brother. Who the hell knows? But he looks cool. He's got the eyebrow going, which is one. But he has the sunglasses and the shades that make him look badass. Kind of like the way Sabo had, like, shades and shit like that. That was actually kind of cool. So it kind of reminds me of the shades of, like, Sabo or something. That was actually really cool. But my heart broke because, no chapter. Even though it sucked because we had Golden Week. And now there's another one. And another, like, a break. Oh, come on, Oda. Ugh. Like, whatever though. So, alright, I'm done. So, that's my overall thoughts. I went on a bit too long with this. So, 4.5 out of 5. Great, great plus chapter. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below of this week's chapter of One Piece. Wah. And I will see you guys not next week, of course, which it could have been. It will be the following week for chapter 826 live reaction / review. Oh my God, the hype is real, man. Gourmet 66. Oh my God. I'm telling you, Oda is going straight fire with this arc, man. This is definitely leaps and bounds way better than freaking than Dressrosa. Like, I think this might be my new favorite arc now. I think it's, oh my God. Like, it just keeps getting much more better, and I'm starting to love this series even more now. So, yeah, okay. So until then, that's it, guys. Ninja Reviewer signing out. Peace, soul, love, chicken grease, and the sky's the limit. MM Manga Fansky, supporting what you read and what you watch. I'll see you guys in a few weeks for chapter 826. So...